Divine True Spirit Discussions. Discussions with people who have lived on earth and who have now passed into the spirit world. Jesus and Mary helped Vietnamese women who passed from 30 to 8,000 years ago, who have asked about the meaning of life. The session was recorded on the 10th of December 2015 in Wilkesdale, Queensland, Australia.
Welcome again. Myself and Mary again are doing some mediumship today. We're doing some informal mediumship, I suppose we'd call it, but we decided to record it anyway. Yeah. We'll see what happens. And again, I don't know very much about the persons who will be channeling, but I'm sure that'll become plain during the mediumship. So thanks, Mary, for doing that for us. We'll just have a little pause while Mary sets herself up and then we'll get going. Thank you.
So Rachel's brought a group of ladies mm-hmm. to me. They're Vietnamese mm-hmm. when they lived on Earth, and they have a spokesperson mm-hmm. whose name is, I think I say, Quong-Li.
Quong-Li.
Spelled Q-U-O-N-G mm-hmm. space L-I.
Yep, Quong-Li.
That's mm-hmm. What I understand anyway. And they want to know what is... Well, I'll let them explain, but what they've said to me is they want to know the meaning of life. Mm-hmm. So, okay. Hello, I'm Quong-Li.
Hello, Quong-Li.
There is a group of us, mm-hmm. around 3,000 of us, who we were brought here by the Bright Lady mm-hmm. because we have been searching for many years now to understand this question, the meaning of life.
Yes.
We feel we lived a life of duty on earth. Mm-hmm. We worked hard and we did what was expected of us. And we taught our daughters to do the same. Mm-hmm. But since arriving here, we saw many things that we were not aware of when we were on earth. And now we have so many questions and some feelings, almost like regret, or we do not understand if we did the right or wrong thing. Mm-hmm. We were sure it was right.
At the time,
but now there are many feelings that we have that make it feel as if what we did was wrong.
Yes.
But we do not wish to say it was wrong because everything we were taught was that it was right. Mm-hmm. So we feel troubled and confused, and we have been asking for a long time for the answer to this, and we have consulted many who we encountered. Mm-hmm. We passed all at various times, and we quickly learned that there was this other life. But we could see many things on earth, and even we saw women in other countries who did not live as we did. Mm. We didn't know about them. Mm. And now we see there are so many ways to live a life on earth. Mm. And we have troubled feelings about what we did and if we taught our daughters well. Mm. Some of us feel angry. And some just confused. Mm. If you can help us, we would be so, so appreciative, so happy.
Mm. I'm pretty sure we'd be able to help, but perhaps if I can just get a little bit of background first. When was the last person who passed in your group? When did they pass?
Not so long ago. We are a large group mm-hmm. and we all come from villages, mm-hmm. not from cities yes. in Vietnam. Yep. And we passed, some of us passed very long ago by Earth standards.
So how long ago?
8,000.
Yeah.
8,000 years.
Mm-hmm.
And some of us as recently as 50,
mm-hmm.
30 years even.
Mm-hmm.
But we all experienced a very similar
lifestyle.
Yes.
Mm.
We worked physically.
Yes.
In fields.
Yes.
We did many, many things for our village and for our families.
Yes.
And there were very, very few days when we did not work physically. And we lived what seems to be now a life of denial of ourselves. And we never questioned this. We always thought that this was our life. This was our duty. We never questioned.
Mm. Well, Quong-Li, I understand the problem and I can feel the emotions as well. So I understand what you're saying. I just wanted to get a bit of background so that the people who are hearing what we're saying also can benefit from what we're saying to you. Does that make sense? Because there's people on Earth, as you know, who have exactly the same question, and that same question is also unresolved for them. In other words, they live a life of duty, a life that they think they're doing the right thing without too much thought about it being needing to be different or even being different. And we'd like to help them as well as yourselves, if we can. Does that make sense?
Yes, if it can help others, then we would want this. We have many concerns for the women from our clans and families who are still on Earth.
And still, in a way, living a very similar life, although they now have some technology.
Yes, but it is much the same. The feeling or the role of a woman is, it's so alike through generations.
It is unfortunately the case. And you will notice that there's no men with you.
No. And
in some cases you feel that that's a good thing.
Well, it is not strange to us. Mm-hmm. We always lived a life separate from
the men. The men, you know, were involved in the procreative process, I suppose, but most of the time they were involved in other things, weren't they, in your day-to-day life?
Yes.
Mm. And you can observe on Earth that there is a large separation between the genders still, isn't there? Many men live their own life and many women live their own life, and very few times do they really come together emotionally. They might come together sexually, but not necessarily emotionally.
Yes. Mm. Although we see that the labour which occurs, the work which occurs in other societies different from our own, there is much more work on the part of men.
Mm-hmm.
And
whereas in your society, the men often would be more of an autocratic ruler of their families, and the family took care of the man rather than the other way around.
There were so many days when we were so exhausted in our bones from the labour, and we never thought that men should do more. They always did less than us, directed us, and sat much more than us.
Yes. You notice also that particularly in some countries on Earth, in particularly the African countries on Earth, that same thing is occurring right now.
Yes.
Where the men are doing a lot of talking and using the resources that women create. So it is still a problem, isn't it, on the Earth, obviously?
Yes.
So a part of the problem, I suppose what I'm trying to illustrate to you, is a part of the problem is how men have treated you. And a part of the problem is how you've learned to treat yourself. Does that make sense?
And we would not have even thought that it was men treating us a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
Simply that we did what every woman should do. This is how we thought.
Yes, but the men defined what a woman should do. The women themselves didn't define it. They were taught it by their fathers and their grandfathers and so forth.
Yes, but we would have said it was our mothers who taught us.
Of course, but your mothers had already been indoctrinated in the same line of thinking. So the next generation of women were indoctrinated by the male-based domination that occurred in your environment.
It is so strange because we never think of it in this way, that we understand there is division between the men, and indeed some of us have resentment towards the men, but we have always felt that it is a line of women who has taught us how to be and how to view ourselves. And we have never really considered that men have an active role in that. Although
you can see quite clearly, though, that if you had acted differently, the men in particular would have violently reacted to you.
Yes, the men and our mothers and our mothers-in-law.
But the mothers and mothers-in-law's reaction are based upon their fears. So their reaction would have been certainly one of punishing you, but they would have been punishing you because of their fears and also another emotion, which is an emotion of emotion that many people have, and that is whatever the parent happened to the parent, they usually want to also have happened to the child. In other words, they don't want the child to have a better experience, in many cases, than their own experience.
This we understand. Our mothers were harsh upon us. And in fact, we know now we were very harsh upon our daughters. And there is something we still do not grasp about this issue with the men.
Yes, you're, and I'm digressing a little, but it's important for later in this discussion. And it's important for you to see that the reason why yourselves as women didn't have an open mind about the possibilities, which you now have an open mind about because you've observed women living in different countries, and particularly in more affluent countries.
Yes.
And then you've examined their particular lifestyle, and you can see that they are often more valued or honoured in the family. And also they have much, much more freedom of choice and decision than what you had when you were on Earth.
Yes, so many. As a woman in our culture or in our villages, we viewed ourselves as workers or labourers or similar to the animals, not animals, but similar in our, we must physically labour.
But see, even the treatment of men generally was that women were animals, that women were their possessions.
Yes.
That women were, could be told what to do and could be demanded of things. They were treated as if they were less intelligent, and you now know that not to be true, you know, that intelligence isn't dependent upon your gender. And so men generally treated you badly in a lot of different ways. And one of the reasons why you are finding progress difficult in the spirit world is because you're yet to see the truth of how you were treated. And that will bring up emotions that you've denied to yourselves that are actually existing inside of you that you will feel. And we want to talk more about that.
So is it... there are two things we wish to raise. One is that, firstly, is not every man in our culture taught by his father and his mother? And so how can he be responsible for how he treated us? Just as...
We'll talk about that principle. Yeah.
And the second is it wrong what we did? Is it right what happens to these other Western women who seem to have so much choice and they make decisions and they do not work as we worked? Is that right? Were we wrong?
Well, firstly, we have to find out whose definition of right and wrong are we talking about, don't we? And, you know, obviously, from your perspective, what you did was not wrong. But from their perspective, if they were put in the same situation as you, they would obviously complain bitterly. And so they would obviously believe it's wrong. So, you know, you can see, firstly, that the perspective of individuals on the earth varies quite considerably. And what I'm suggesting is that actually there needs to be another perspective, not a perspective that's governed by the person's upbringing or their background or what they were taught, but rather another perspective, which is the perspective of love that I'd like to introduce to you.
Will this help us with this turmoil that we feel inside?
Certainly it will. But what I would like to do first is explain a number of very basic things about the spirit world, just to confirm whether you've learnt them or not, because I feel there's a number of things that you have not yet learned about the spirit world that are essential part of this discussion. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Now, the lady who brought you here, you notice that she's a very bright spirit, isn't she?
Very beautiful, very kind.
Yes. And you can see that she's very loving and considerate of you.
Yes.
Can you also see that she had a similar life to you in the past? If she projects at you some of the images of her life on Earth, what do you notice?
Yes, she had some hardship in her life.
So what time period did she live?
She lived in the first century.
Mm-hmm. So 2,000 years ago.
Yes.
And women were treated very similarly to the women who, how you've been treated.
Yes.
And very similarly to how women get treated still in many countries of the earth today.
Yes.
Mm. Now, the question then becomes, well, she has had a very similar background, but she's now happy, and she's now quite, she's obviously happy because you can see how happy she is. But she's also quite bright and also quite powerful, isn't she? And she makes a suggestion to you. You feel impelled to give it consideration, don't you? Because of how bright and happy she is.
Yes.
And that power of her love, I suppose you could say, motivates you to maybe follow her direction. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So then the question becomes is, how did she get from the condition, which was very, very similar to the condition that you faced in your lives on Earth, how did she get from that condition to the condition she's in now?
Yes, we would very much like to know.
So that's a very important question, isn't it? And the answer to that question involves a discussion about love. Mm-hmm. Now, the way the universe works is that God does exist, and even though you have not seen God, God certainly does exist, and we will do an experiment shortly to see whether we can prove that God exists or not. Okay. But God has created a universe that is based around laws that are governed by love. And the problem on Earth is that humankind have made a whole series of laws that are not governed by love, but rather governed by domination and abuse, dominated by fear. And so humankind have created a society on Earth which is very, very opposite to the society that God would like humankind to engage on Earth.
So we are not wrong to feel that there was something wrong with
Correct.
How we lived.
And I can explain further. God wants every person on Earth to live in a state of happiness and well-being. God does not want every person on Earth to work all of their days. God wants every person on Earth to enjoy their life and to have freedom. Now, these are not the things that you experienced on Earth. And because of the differences between the two things, this is why you feel the way you do. Does that make sense?
Yes, we.
Now, humankind.
We could not. Sorry.
Go on. Humankind created this condition on Earth, not God. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, yes. We have been going back and forth, thinking when we came here first, it felt bad for all of us to see these other ways. And then we doubted that feeling. We felt we should not have this feeling. It is the duty of a woman and to do as we did, and we did right by that. And so this terrible feeling we tried to
suppress,
mm-hmm. but it kept coming, and we mm-hmm. didn't know what was right or wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, so this makes sense.
Yes, so what I want to say categorically is that how you were treated on earth was very wrong. But it wasn't God's desire to have you treated that way. It was humankind's creation that you got treated that way. And we need to make the distinction between that. It was the choices, and in particular in your environment, the choices of men and the women they trained to enforce the society that you lived in. And they made that choice, which is a very great sin from God's perspective. Now, what I mean by sin is every time we miss the mark of love, then we have sinned from God's perspective. And humankind, every single day, engages in a lot of sin because they miss the mark of love. And many of them were taught to sin, just as you have been taught to sin. In other words, you were taught to treat women badly, just like animals, just like you were treated. Somebody taught you to treat other women like that. And you were also taught to accept the domination and the brute force of man. You were taught that, and fear caused you to be taught those things. Does that make sense? And as a result of these things being taught to you, you then engaged in a life that would only be dominated by the things you were taught. And the beauty of arriving in the spirit world after you've passed is you've had the ability to examine all sorts of other lives and therefore see a contrast between the life you were taught to live and the lives that other women on the planet live. Now, I'm not suggesting that those women also live their lives in harmony with love, because many of those women are actually dominating men, which is just as bad as a man dominating a woman. Does that make sense? God created us all to be equal and have freedom rather than have a relationship based on some kind of domination or power of one gender over the other.
How can this happen?
Well, it happens because of the choices of humankind. Every time we walk away from love, every time we make a choice to go away from love, we choose to act out of harmony with love and therefore in harmony with fear and other emotions. And in the choices we make, we create a whole heap of negative consequences. And the reason why God made a system that where we become responsible is that at some point we need to see what we create. So by your accepting the way you were taught without question, you then created things that you are not happy about now. And by you accepting abuse from men in particular, you have created things that you are not happy about now. Now the men, the reason why you don't see the men is because the men are in a very, very dark condition. They are in fact, almost in an evil state because they have treated you this way. And every single law that we break from God's perspective results in a penalty of some kind. They broke the law with regard to harming other people's free will and harming other people by demonstrating a lack of love. They also developed superiority over you. They also viewed you as not being equal to them. And there is so many ways in which they sinned from God's perspective that this has caused them to be in a very, very dark condition.
Some of what you're saying is frightening us about mm-hmm. the fact that we felt things that were so right on earth.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as we came here, there were other terrible feelings that we began to have. Do the men feel these same terrible feelings?
Well, many of the men are not even in the condition yet where they realize what they feel. They are in such a dark condition.
We do not place an emphasis on feelings.
I know, but in time, I feel you will.
No, I mean everyone in the culture.
I know that. Yes, I know what you mean. And yes, I agree, but but in time I feel you will. Does that make sense? And I'll talk to you about why. What I would like to do, though, is just make sure you understand a few of these basic principles first. So if we get not too bogged down in the reflections, okay, and we talk more about the actual principles, that would be good. So the first thing that is a principle is that God rules the universe and God's laws of love rule the universe. But humankind have the free will to choose to do what they wish. But in the choice, they have a responsibility and they bear the penalty of choosing out of harmony with love. And they bear the joy of choosing in harmony with love. Now, the lady who's in front of you, it's Rachel, her name is, isn't it?
Yes.
She has obviously chosen a lot in harmony with love. And as a result, she is in a very happy and bright condition. And the brightness is a demonstration of how much love she actually demonstrates. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that becomes very paramount in your life in the spirit world is learning about love. Now, you asked at the beginning of our conversation, what is the point of our existence? What is the purpose for our being here?
Mm.
Well, God created us so that we could experience God's love. That's the point. Now, most people on earth reject it, and so they never get to experience it. Right?
How can we know this truth on earth?
Well, the truth hasn't been known well on earth for long periods of time. And there's reasons for that. And that is because basically humankind made a choice to leave God's love, right? A long time before you arrived on earth. And that choice to leave God's love has caused a lot of the damage that we experience when we're on earth.
Can we tell the women now?
Of course you can.
On earth, that this is the point.
Yes. But if we understand the point a bit further, okay, God, in her love for you, has created a universe in which you can play. But your ability to play in this universe depends completely upon how much love you actually have. So what? The more love you have, the less restricted you are. Now, that doesn't apply on earth, but it does apply in the spirit world.
What is play?
Play is doing things that you just desire to do, not having to work all the time. Doing things because you're interested in them and because you like them and they make you feel happy.
How do we know what our desires are?
Well, that requires your feelings. You need to be able to feel, and this is why your feelings become important.
Okay.
All right. So firstly, I wanted to say this one truth, and that is that the universe is governed by love, and if you grow in love, you will have less restriction.
Okay.
And we're talking here about God's definition of love, not your own.
Okay, we can learn.
You can learn that easy enough, right?
I don't know how, but we'll learn.
Yeah, I'm sure you will. And in fact, women generally have a much easier time learning about love, because generally on earth they are less suppressed emotionally than the men are. The men are even more suppressed generally than the women. And as a result, the women generally find learning about love a little easier once they arrive in the spirit world.
Okay.
Now that applies to women who have been oppressed. Now obviously if women have been the oppressor, just as the men in your culture have been, then obviously they wouldn't know much about love at all and therefore would have a lot to learn about love. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Whenever we choose to oppress another, we have lost the learning about love. We are no longer being loving.
But didn't we suppress our daughters, oppress our daughters?
Of course.
There is a lot of feeling about this amongst our group.
Yes. But see, God doesn't punish you. The penalty is where you are right now. So you can't get into a worse state by acknowledging these emotions. Do you follow me?
Okay.
The penalty for the oppression that you conducted upon your daughters, for example, is already being experienced by you right now. You are not going to receive any more penalties as a choice because of that decision that you made years ago.
So really? Really? Nothing?
No, because where you are right now is the penalty. You're living in the penalty right now.
What do you mean?
Well, every law has a happy consequence if we obey it, and it has a penalty associated if we don't. The penalty that's associated with the laws that you broke, were revolving around the issues of self-love and self-care. In other words, God expects you to care for yourself as much as God expects you to care for any other person. The care should be equal. Now, you ladies cared more for the men in your life than you did for yourselves or for your women children. The male children were honoured, and the female children were treated the same way you were treated.
Yes.
This is the sin that you engaged in while you're on earth. Does that make sense? You didn't know it to be a sin at the time because you were browbeaten and abused by men in your culture into having this attitude. And the fear that you had of these men caused you to engage the behaviour.
Yes.
So what I'm doing is trying to explain to you the psychology of what's gone on in your life.
But where we are, you mentioned the penalty.
Mm-hmm.
Where we are does not, well, it does not seem so bad.
No, because you did not engage in the same kind of abuse as the men in your life engaged with you.
We feel terrible guilt about what...
What I would like to do is have Rachel, just for a moment, take you to the place, and there's no need to be scared, although you probably will be, so it's just a temporary thing, and she'll bring you back to here so we can continue our discussion. And this process won't harm you in any way aside from helping you see where the men who were involved in your life are.
But, if we go to them, should we, it feels like we have to stay and look after them.
You definitely should not stay. And you definitely should not look after them. So I'm saying to you, that would be a very unloving thing to do.
How will we stop it?
You come back here. You can stop it by coming back here.
It's a lot of us feel like we're not allowed. Once we see them, we must stay.
No, definitely not. That's the feeling they gave you. That's what they wanted you to believe.
What if they are...
What if they are?
Well, need us. What if they...
No, they will think they need you. They will want to abuse you. And I'm saying to you, you need to no longer allow it because it's unloving to yourself. So a part of this process is to visit them but not stay. And what we'll do is we'll visit them, but you're not going to visit them right close by. I just need you to observe them. Does that make sense? There's a high likelihood they will not even see you.
Okay.
But if they do see you, definitely do not stay. And any of your sisters that are there all need to come away from that location if you go there. Do you follow me? And Rachel will help you come back to here, come back to this discussion.
Okay.
And I need to emphasize this to you. I definitely do not want you to stay under any circumstances, no matter what the men say to you. You are not to stay. It would be very negative and damaging to you if you do. Do you follow me?
We have never looked for them because...
Because you're being concerned that you'd have to look after them more if you found them. Yes. I am only wanting to show you the condition they're in so that I can illustrate that they had a very much more lack of love than you had.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
And it's very important that you come back to this discussion. So all of you need to promise that you're going to come back to this discussion. Rachel will help you come back.
Yes, she says she will help us and put a barrier. Put a barrier.
So that the men cannot have any effect on you. And I would like that you don't communicate with the men. You don't talk to them.
That's okay, we won't.
Okay. So what Rachel's going to do is just take you to them briefly and then come back. What did you notice?
They look old and hunched and very disfigured.
Mm-hmm.
And they can hardly walk.
Mm-hmm.
And they moan and mumble and wander around.
Mm-hmm.
It's dark.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them looking for us.
They don't need to worry. You're in a brighter condition, and the only way that you can be harmed is that you go to them. You don't need to go to them.
They can't find us?
They can't find you where you are, no.
Oh, okay.
So you mustn't follow their desire. Every time they project at you a desire, then you'll see something coming from them. And don't follow that. Don't follow that desire. Because it'd be very damaging to you to go back to a life that you had with them.
It is definitely wrong. Can you reassure us?
Yes, it's definitely wrong.
It is definitely wrong to live with them?
Yes. At the moment, yes. They need to make many improvements in their life
before
you would even consider having anything to do with them. Do you follow me? Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's very important that you do not have anything to do with them at this stage. The only reason why I was asking you to go there is so that you can see the state that they are in. So what do you notice about the state they're in?
Not nice.
No.
And they look worse than they did on Earth. And
correct.
Even as old men, they look old, old, hunched, like...
Diseased.
Mm. Grey.
Mm-hmm. Like, now, can I show you why?
What? We feel so bad. Guilty.
You feel bad and guilty because they taught you to feel bad and guilty. And you must understand this. This is one of the reasons why I've asked you to go and have a look at them. Because it's very important that you no longer feel bad or guilty about them. They have made their choices and now they bear the penalty of such choices.
We wish we didn't see them because now... Feels bad.
Why does it feel bad?
Now we feel frightened and guilty more. Is a woman's duty? We have to go.
No, it's very important you do not go. Very important you do not go. Besides, you promised.
Okay.
Didn't you?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now you ask Rachel whether she would go to them. And spend and do things for them.
No, she says no.
So if she's in a brighter condition than you and in a more loving space than you, is what we've determined, then it makes sense, doesn't it, that you're not doing anything wrong by avoiding these men.
Some of us do not have our daughters with us. Are our daughters going to go to them? We cannot...
Many of you with your daughters have already progressed beyond where you are to an even brighter place.
Then some are with us, but some are not.
Would you like to see some of the ones who are not?
Yes.
All right, we'll see whether we can organise that. But again, I'd like you to not be too distracted by it because we've got a lot more to discuss.
Okay. Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay to feel emotions, but the key is to not live in them.
What do you mean?
Well, you know how you feel the feeling of guilt about not going back to the men. It's okay to feel that feeling and to just process it and have a cry if you need to. But it's very important you don't live in it by going back to the man. Do you see the difference?
Okay, yes.
You can choose to feel your emotion without actually doing anything about it.
Okay.
It is very, very important that you learn to feel your emotions that are negative without doing anything about them. And guilt is a negative emotion. There's no need for you to feel guilty here. In fact, from God's perspective, the men have sinned much more than you ever have, and they themselves need to pay the penalty for such a sin.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
So you're allowed to feel your emotions, just don't act upon them, unless you know for certain they're in harmony with love. Now, you don't know for certain that this emotion of guilt is in harmony with love at this point. You only know that you've been taught to feel guilty by these men. Right? And those men are in a very dark condition, which would indicate that they don't know much about love at all. And so
it would
be very, very unwise to trust what they say to you. Do you understand?
Okay, yes, yes.
Anybody who's in a darker condition than yourself, it is very unwise to trust them.
We forgot this. You told us this. We forgot.
Mm-hmm. You only want to be able to trust the people who are in a brighter condition than yourself.
And because do we deserve that?
Of course.
Do we deserve?
Well, from God's perspective, everyone deserves love. So remember that you've been used to mankind's perspective, which has been very damaging to you, and it's been very harmful, and you'll have, like you have now, some tears to cry. And that's okay. Remember not to act upon them. You're allowed to cry. Just don't go and do something that's in harmony with living in that place.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Crying is really good for you. Any emotion, feeling any emotion is really good for you. Any emotion will help you get out of the place you are currently in. Does that make sense?
Okay.
But doing something about that emotion and living in harmony with that emotion isn't always wise. The only time we should live in harmony with an emotion is if we know for certain that the emotion is a loving one. And the fact that these men are projecting at you that they want you back with them, and you know that they are in a much worse condition than yourselves, is an indication that you should not trust what they are saying.
Okay.
You only trust the people who are in a more loving condition than yourself. This is a very important rule that you need to follow.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. That's it. So allow to feel your feelings, but don't go and do something that causes you to be in a harmful location. And where these men are living is in a harmful location. You don't deserve to be there, nor do you need to be there. And from God's perspective, you certainly don't need to be there at all.
Okay.
It is only the strong demands of these men that make you feel guilty. But they are in an unloving condition. So this means that their demand is unloving and should not be acceded to. It shouldn't be followed.
Yes, you told us we have to learn the love, learn God's.
It's very important.
Love.
It's going to be easier later for you to do that after I've explained a few more things.
Okay.
Okay. At the moment it's hard because you feel drawn because of your guilt. And that's what they've manipulated. These men have manipulated the emotion of guilt inside of you, and they've manipulated you to look after them, which is out of harmony with love. You follow? Now, remember in our conversation, we were talking about bringing some of your daughters to you. We're trying to organise that, so I think that's fairly well organised now. Now, a lot of your daughters have been really wanting to meet you for a long time. can you see that they are brighter too?
So beautiful.
Hmm.
So happy.
Mm, it's so, so wonderful, beautiful. Isn't it? Hmm. Do you know why they haven't come sooner?
No.
Because they couldn't shake you from this belief that you had to stay where you were. Does that make sense? And so you couldn't see them even.
This is so happy for so many of us.
Mm-hmm. Mm, it's wonderful, isn't it?
And we have worried for them.
Yes. But they realized some things before you did. And that's what's helped them grow into a better condition of love. Does that make sense?
They forgive us.
Hmm. They know what the cause of the problem was. If you talk to them more honestly about the real cause, they can see that a lot of it was triggered by the men and their belief systems and their abusive demands.
We have tortured ourselves with what we did to them.
Yeah. And that's a part of the penalty that I was talking about earlier. The penalty of the choices that we make that are out of harmony with love. A lot of that is the feelings of torture that we have towards ourselves.
We did not ever feel that we could be forgiven.
Yeah. It's wonderful that you can, isn't it?
Thank you so much for this.
Mm.
We thought they must hate us.
Mm. No, the problem is they knew that you were very, very still steeped in this idea or concept that the woman's role of what the woman's role is.
And why is it that some of our daughters came to be with us, but these other ones did not? Some of us have daughters who are here with us,
mm-hmm.
and some have daughters who have never come, who have just come.
Mm-hmm.
Why is there a difference?
Well, the daughters who are with you all the time that you've been there, they have all had the same beliefs as you. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Whereas the daughters that have come just now, who are brighter than you, they learnt some lessons of love before you have. And so they progressed. Remember I said progression in the universe is all about how much love you have. And they learnt that.
Many of those who have not been with us have been our eldest daughters.
Yes.
And those we treated most harshly, and we thought that they would not come because they hated us.
Mm. But many of them, because they had been treated more harshly, felt and knew earlier than you that something was terribly wrong. And as a result of them knowing that something was terribly wrong, they decided to investigate for themselves things that they wouldn't have otherwise have probably investigated. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And it's very fortunate they did for themselves, but also for you, because they have the ability to help you now. Mm.
Thank you so much.
Do any of you have your daughters missing at this point?
Only a few of us. Yes, a few are still wondering about their daughters.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Rachel says she will help them. Mm-hmm. Find them.
Yes, and help them to understand why they haven't come at this point. Does that make sense? The spirit world's a very large place, and there's reasons why. Now, certain ones of your daughters have chosen to do worse things than you did. Does that make sense?
Oh, no.
Yeah. And so naturally, they can't be where you are right now. But they're not in as bad a condition as the men.
Good, good.
Hmm.
We must help.
Yes, you'll be able to help them when you understand how everything works.
And we must help our granddaughters and our great-granddaughters.
Mm. And even, why not, the women who are on Earth?
Yes. Mm.
If you can.
Yes.
Mm. Mm. Now, remember we were talking a bit about before this about God and God's love. You remember that? So you can see from your other daughters that arrived earlier that God obviously wants you to be happier than you are now. And God doesn't want you to be driven by this guilt and shame that you have, and God doesn't want you to do a whole heap of things for men for no purpose or reason.
But how can we...
How can we earn
these things from God?
You don't have to earn it. Love is not something that can be earned. If it was, then it wouldn't be love, would it? Love is something that's a gift that's given, and all we require is the openness to receive it. It's like when somebody gives you a gift, like Rachel brought you your daughters, that was a gift, yes? All you had to be... is open to receive them.
We do not understand this.
Mm. You don't understand that principle of love because that principle of love is not taught on the earth. On the earth, everybody teaches that you've got to earn love, that something has to be done for it. You see? But that's very, very different than God's viewpoint of love. Okay.
This is hard, but...
Yes, no, it's emotional. Let's call it emotional, shall we? Because you'll find after a while that emotions are not that hard. And if I just give Mary a... She's reflecting some of your emotions there. Things don't have to be traumatic and hard like they were on the earth for you, right? But you accepted that life for reasons, and those reasons need to be dealt with.
We cannot understand this new reality.
Well, I think you will understand it in time. It'll take your time.
It's too good for
No, us. Nothing's too good for God's children. That's how God feels. Nothing's too good for them. They only need to learn the lessons of love in order to receive them, the gifts that God has to give, you know.
We will learn. We will learn.
Yes, I feel pretty sure you will. But can I share a few more things with you that will help you in that process? Firstly, God can tell you how God feels about you. Would you like to know how God feels about you? Some of you are frightened of that idea.
This God, man.
God has male and female qualities, and there are plenty of men who are capable of loving you. Would you like to meet a few men who are capable of loving you? Men who are nice men? Because you've never met a nice man, really, on earth, have you?
Well, we thought men were all the same, but not nice or not nice, just they are a certain way and we are separate from them.
Yeah, and it's not the case at all in the higher spheres of the spirit world where more love is. There are just as many men as women there. And the men don't require the women to work for them or do things for them or cook for them or clean for them or any of the other things. Because the men are responsible for themselves. Does that make sense?
We have seen this in some places on earth, but we don't trust them very much.
No.
Sometimes they seem to do things but not feel good about the woman.
Yes. Sometimes they do things to get other things from the woman, don't they? So they want to get sex from the woman or something, so they do something for the woman in order to get that.
And it seems like duty still. It seems like women still have duty.
Yes. And that's not what I'm talking about here.
Okay.
I would like to introduce you to some men because it will help you understand that they are good men too.
Oh. Hmm. Oh.
They're nice men, huh?
Men from our culture.
Yes, men from your culture who have learnt about what they did and decided that they wanted to become more loving people. And you see that, remember, they're brighter?
So bright.
Yeah, so you can see anybody who's bright. What's the lesson there? Anybody who's bright has
more love, more love. Better condition.
Yeah, so you can see that they have more love and a better condition. They're very, very different looking and feeling from the men that you just went and visited in the hills.
It is almost like that. We know they're not, but it's like a mythical creature. That's so cool.
Hmm.
Sorry, but
it's okay. You're bound to feel overwhelmed. Many of you have lived in this state for such a long time that you haven't been aware of what's possible. And so I'm just introducing you to things that are increasing your awareness of what is possible. And it is possible to have men who are in good condition, just like it's possible to have women that are in good condition. Make sense? So I know you're emotional and that's good. You need to just let yourself feel these emotions.
Okay.
But if we can mention one or two more things before you go and have a good cry.
Okay.
There's been a lot of new revelations happening for you and, you know, obviously that's going to be an emotional process, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Particularly for many of you who've lived such a long time in the spirit world in the same state.
So long, we can.
You can hardly remember when you were on Earth.
We thought it would be forever the way it was, but we just wanted to understand what was right and what was wrong.
And it's good that you wanted to understand that, because that's what caused Rachel to bring you to this discussion.
We are very grateful.
So basically what we're saying to this point is that what is right is what's loving and what is wrong is what's unloving.
And we must learn what is loving.
From God's perspective.
Yes, you taught us already.
Yes.
Yes.
That's it. So what I'm going to do now is introduce you to God's perspective.
Oh.
Does that make sense?
We just realised something.
Well, what did you realise?
You are a man. She brought us in. We were so desperate for an answer. We didn't
really notice I was a man in the first place. I know.
Sorry.
That's what happens, though, you see. We're so used to seeing one gender a certain way, that we think all of the same gender are the same way.
Yes.
It's not true.
We have thought this.
Hmm.
And
it's not true, is it?
You do not treat your woman like an enemy.
Yeah. And the men that are in front of you, they wouldn't treat a woman like you've been treated either, would they?
It's almost like we must redefine ourselves because mm-hmm. they do not view us like a creature, but something else entirely, and we have not considered ourselves as this other thing that they think of us as.
They think of you as a child of God.
And we feel this so much more strongly from them than we do from Rachel. We feel the difference.
Because you've never felt it from a man before. Does that make sense?
Yes,
and so the contrast of what you've lived in with men and what these men are like is very, very high contrast. It's very different. And that's what causes you to notice it so much.
Yes, 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 that makes perfect sense.
Yeah. So Rachel has the same view of you than these men have. But because you've never had this feeling from a man before, it's a very big thing in comparison to Rachel's care and concern for you.
Yes, it's very true.
Hmm.
Please, you have more to teach us, or we should learn.
Mm-hmm. So what I would like to do now is teach you about this relationship with God that is possible.
Okay. Right?
God wants to tell you things that are true, and God only wants to share the truth with you. So we can ask questions of God, and the way we ask questions has to do with our heart, how we feel. And this is why it was very important that you let yourself feel. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So what's a question you would have liked to have known the answer to?
What is the right way for a woman to live?
Okay, so what say we ask God, but it has to come from your heart, it can't be just a thought. You would like to ask God to be shown what is the right way for a woman to live.
And is God like these? Yes, yes.
Let's just try the experiment before you work out what God's like.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
Yeah. So you were asking the question and you really want to know the answer, don't you? You want to know, what is the right way for a woman to live? Okay, we want to ask God that question. God, if you exist, we want to be shown from you what the right way for a woman to live is.
It's not even possible for us to conceive.
But it's where God feels that you deserve to live. It just requires you learning more about love, that's all. Does that make sense?
We cannot even...
Is there another question you'd like to know the answer to?
Oh, okay.
Or is there too many already?
It is so much this one thing.
But what that little illustration did was to show you that if you really had a sincere feeling that you want to know the truth about something, all you need to do is be open to hear what the answer to the question is from God. That's all you need to do. If you really want to know. Does that make sense? And if God was a loving God and loving parent, you would think that God would want to do these things.
Yes, we were taught a way to live, and we are ready to learn.
So what were you shown from God about how a woman should live?
Oh, it's too... We feel shock. It's...
so different to anything we've ever seen.
Yeah. Or experience.
Happiness and and expression and relaxation and happiness and beautiful things and
music and art and all of those things being shown to you.
Things we don't know anything about.
That's okay. You can learn, right?
We cannot even understand it all.
Mm. Yeah.
Oh, we need to...
I want you to stay with me for one or two more things to show you if I can. Is that okay? Remember, just feel your feelings, like I said. You don't have to act upon them.
It's a large shock. This is a large shock.
Again, it's the contrast between what you've lived and what God would have liked you to have lived.
We're afraid to hope for something so good.
Yeah, but there's no need to be afraid with anything with God. God wants what is best for you. God loves you. Now, at this stage, you don't know whether God loves you.
No. Well, it seems he must if this is what we...
Which is, it does seem that he must if this is the possibility, right? Yeah. Would you like to know?
Yes, we would.
Because all we need to do is the same question, but this time about God's love. So... just say to God that you would like to feel some of God's love for you if God has love for you. Remember, you just need to let the emotion flow, it's fine.
We can't be worthy of this. Such a feeling exists.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Oh, my goodness. We feel so many new things now.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. It's okay. Remember, you don't have to act on anything. You just need to let yourself feel.
Oh, my goodness. There is... so many changes all of a sudden.
Yes. What do you notice?
Oh. Inside of me there is just so many different feelings now.
Yeah.
That I never knew that I had.
Some of them good and some of them not so good.
Yes. Yeah. Fear.
Yeah.
Oh, I never know.
Yeah. So you need to let yourself feel without acting upon it, remember.
But around us, there's colour.
Yes. So what's happened in your environment?
It's better. It's more beautiful than we ever have seen before, ever.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can be happy forever now.
Well, one thing I would like to say to you is that God's got a lot more in store for you than you'd ever know at this point.
Even this is so wonderful.
But what I'm saying to you is there's things above that and above that and above that too. And what I'm suggesting to you is to not think that God isn't abundant. Don't think that where you are now is all God has in store for you. Because God's got even more in store for you. If you're willing to receive it. So you don't want to stay where you are thinking that that's all there is.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes, it is very hard to
imagine
conceive.
Anything better, right?
Yes, but already it is so different to how we've lived for so long.
Yeah.
I cannot understand. We thank you very, very much.
It's a pleasure. But all that's happened here is that you've received some of God's love. So it's really God that you should be thanking.
Yes. And our daughters and these men and Rachel and everyone.
Mm-hmm. Mm. So what I'm going to suggest to you is that this is just the beginning of your life. And there's probably things you want to do now and look at now and see now and examine, but don't give up the thought that there's even better things out there than what you can imagine. Does that make sense? You don't want to stay stuck in a place like you were before.
No. No.
See,
so much time
goes
spent
by
without knowing possibility.
That's right. And what I'm
looking
suggesting
for answers,
you,
looking for answers. Why do we have answers now?
Because that's what comes with God's love. As God's love comes to you, so does the answers to a lot of questions automatically come to you. Does that make sense?
But why now did we suddenly find you and find
Well, because
answers.
You were ready to know the answers. Does that make sense? You were ready to know them.
Yeah.
Up until then, you weren't ready to know them. How many times had some of those daughters of yours who were brighter tried to come to you? And you couldn't hear them. And
so
you couldn't,
many, and we didn't.
You couldn't hear them and you couldn't see them. Because you were closed to the possibility, you see.
We thought they must.
And that's why, and that's why I'm saying to you that you need to not be closed to the possibility, you see.
Okay, yes, we understand now mm-hmm. from the daughters, yes, mm. this makes sense.
Mm. You were closed to the possibility that they'd forgiven you.
So we must learn to be open to possibilities.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And, yes. This is what happened when we came here first, is suddenly we saw different things, but and we thought maybe there's a possibility of something that we did wrong or that was wrong in what we did, and
mm-hmm.
but we never found the answer.
Because you weren't open to the answer. You were worried and you were afraid that you did something that was wrong, that you might be punished for.
Yes.
Or that you might feel really bad about.
Yes, it's true.
And one of the things that I've been saying to you over and over again is that you need to let yourself feel your feelings without acting in harmony with them. So whenever you feel like, no, I don't deserve more, that doesn't mean you don't deserve more. It's just a feeling you have. Do you understand? It's a feeling you need to let yourself feel. Just like you've been feeling your tears and you've been crying, it's the same. Just need to let yourself feel those feelings.
Okay. We have to learn some things.
Mm-hmm. Remember I said everything's about learning about love. And you've learnt the fast way of learning about love, and that is to receive some of God's love. And that teaches you things about love. And God's love and fear can't stay in the same place. So that's why you feel all of a sudden afraid. Right?
Okay.
You notice that you have fear in you now that you didn't notice before.
No.
Hmm. And that's because God's love has exposed it as being something that's opposite to God's love. And now it's up to you to release it. It's up to you to feel the fear without doing anything about it. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Just like you felt other feelings, like the guilt feeling you had when the men were around, and I told you not to do anything about it, just feel it.
Okay.
It's the same as that, but with good feelings as well.
Mm.
Bad or good feelings, you need to let yourself feel, and the ones that are loving, you'll notice, and then you can act upon those. And the ones that are not, like fear and shame and guilt and other emotions, you'll feel and then you'll let go of them. That's what God loves. God's love helps expose to you those emotions if you're open to seeing. But you first need to see.
We will learn. We will be good students.
Mm.
We can learn,
but
this,
not rigid students.
What you talk about. What do you mean?
Well, you're not to be hard on yourself.
This is difficult for us.
I understand that. But that, if you ask God the question, should you be hard on yourself? So what's God saying to you?
So much compassion.
Yeah. So you need to have compassion for yourself. When you have compassion for yourself, you can have compassion for others.
We never, never had this feeling.
So there's lots of things to learn, and being a good student is about learning it in a compassionate way, not in a rigid way.
Okay.
Not to force yourself, but to do it because you like doing it, because you want to. Now, you've not experienced that on Earth, but that's the possibility.
You've helped us experience so much. Thank you.
It's my pleasure.
We would honour you in some way. We do not know how.
Mm. And you've been talking through Mary, her name is, as well. And it's lovely that she's been able to let you talk through her, isn't it?
She's kind.
Mm. One thing I'd like to say to you before you go is that with your relationship with God, you can ask any question and you can always ask for God's love to come, and that will expose new things to you. And it just depends on how fast you want that to happen, as how and how fast you can process the emotion that it brings up. That depends on how fast you'll do that. Does that make sense?
We will learn. We will learn about this.
So my suggestion is let yourself feel your emotions without acting upon them.
Okay.
Right? And when you do that, things will progress very rapidly.
Okay.
Particularly if you ask for God's love to come while you do it.
Okay.
The second thing I'd like to say before you go is that you've got helpers around you. You've got some of your daughters now who can help you, and you've got some men now that can help you too and teach you things that you didn't know before. Some of the men.
It is hard to feel we deserve these things.
Mm. But they're all there for your assistance. They all receive the joy of helping you when they help assist you. If you let them assist you, you will understand a great many things in a short period of time. And if you let yourself feel the emotions you feel, you'll understand as fast and as rapidly as you can. If you shut yourself down emotionally, that will all stop until you open up again. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. So the key is to not be afraid of your emotions.
Okay.
Yeah. God loves you, and God wants to give you more of God's love. If you remember that, you will never feel like you did on Earth.
We thank you, we thank you, we thank you.
It's my pleasure. Now, one question that you can now ask God is this. You can ask God what the purpose of life is.
So different
from what you expected.
So opposite.
Mm.
Joy and love and expression and.
Mm.
Learning and understanding things that we never, ever thought.
Mm. God created the universe so that you can see what I mean now by your playground.
It is so foreign, so foreign what we are being shown.
Mm. And God created us so that we could experience the extreme pleasure of God's love. And to decide to do what we wish to do once we're in that state of love.
Thank you. Thank you. We've taken enough of your time now.
It's been our pleasure.
We thank you so much, and many blessings on you and your family.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Sometimes I feel so privileged to channel them, you know. I get such an insight into
different feelings. And
yeah, and they have so many experiences that I just get to sort of feel without experiencing.
And a lot of their experiences would have been similar to yours in the first century too, which
obviously is triggering something for me, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
For me, I guess the feeling of separating myself and punishing myself and worrying
that you did something wrong when you haven't really done much wrong, that kind of thing.
And feeling like I damaged my children and so many things, probably. It's really lovely to help them.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. You wonder how many Asian women must be in that position, eh?
Yeah, that was a pretty big group, I think, from the feeling from Rachel, you know. Did she say how many of them there were?
3,000 or so, yeah.
Yeah, well.
Some had been there 8,000 years.
Yeah, it's a long time. Wow. Oh, poor darlings, hey?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a long time to beat up on yourself and feel unworthy.
Yeah. Particularly when it's been instigated by others.
Yeah, and the complete lack of, it almost felt, just feeling it now, it's like they didn't even have any rage at men. It was, I mean, I think that will come.
They will do, because it's like, the reason why a lot of women in those positions don't have the rage with men is because they also have a deep belief that what the men are doing to them is what should be done to them. And that's what makes a good woman, type of thing.
Acceptance, yeah.
It's a classic case of like an abused woman living in an abusive household.
Yeah.
But these women have lived in abusive countries. With abusive households.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So it's a epidemic in the country.
Yeah, I feel sad for them.
Mm.
Sad the way so many women and men in different scenarios don't have any concept of themselves as valuable. Yeah.
I think more women than men. Because women have been treated, particularly the last 2,000 or more years, women have been treated with a lot more disrespect than men.
Yeah.
You know, unless, of course, you're a common man, and then obviously it might be a bit different, but even in a common man environment, the women are treated less.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's sort of...
Yeah, and men have been trained sort of... what's the word I want to use? Like that
to believe themselves to be superior.
To believe themselves to have worth and capability to create.
Mm.
Whereas a lot of women, even I feel now in the West, are not really raised with this idea.
They wait for the man to create for them.
Mm. Yeah, and if they do go ahead and create for themselves, they often receive a lot of, you know... Well, often I think some of them do it in an injured way.
Yeah.
But then others I see, they cop a lot of flack for even being a creative person, and often they don't have a man with them.
No.
Yeah.
But I feel too, though, that a lot of the women in their case, come from Africa, Asia, not from the Western countries.
No.
A lot of the women in the Western countries are just as dark and sometimes darker than the men in the Western countries, unfortunately.
Yeah, and I guess what's sort of... That's why the lack of anger struck me, because I see so many Western women full of rage.
Full of rage. But they're just full of rage because of who is overclerking them generally.
Yeah, because often they live... Well, you know, my feelings, they have such a life of privilege.
Life of privilege. But see, what happens, though, with their life of privilege, the spirits like this go around and see that life of privilege, and then the ones that are especially angry connect to that life of privilege and then try to enjoy that life of privilege with those women.
Of course.
But, of course, their rage towards men is quite large as well.
Yeah, and I can feel that now. I think Rachel's helping me to have some examples there of... The lack of trust also of a man.
Mm.
There's a lot of influence happens with these women on earth, from women in spirit world, to don't trust.
No.
Do your thing, enjoy your thing separate from the man, and don't trust him.
Yeah. And a lot of it is historical. It's the spirits who are surrounding the women on earth who are now... Many of them have not experienced anything bad at the hands of men, but unfortunately, the women who are surrounding them have in the spirit world, and so they then display the rage of those women rather than actually have their own feelings about what's actually happened in their own life.
Yeah. Mm. So important to help, I feel, help heal this rift between men and women.
Mm.
It will be good to do that.
Mm. Will be, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, it's a sad thing how historically a lot of these women have been treated, and like a lot of them are still getting treated in, like I said, third world countries in particular.
Yeah, well, you know, I've had a lot
in the Middle East, in the Far East.
Experience seeing that, I suppose.
In Africa.
Well,
even some places of South America.
Yeah, South America... I found a bit funny because it's kind of matriarchal, patriarchal. There's a real war going on that's a subversive kind of thing. Like,
and women have a lot more.
Well, in the home.
Right to make choice and decisions.
Well, not external to the home.
I know.
But in the home.
In the home, they rule.
Which you can kind of be subversive and manipulative and govern what happens outside as well if you do that. And all kinds of things. I suppose that
happens in these other countries, it's been more abusive. Like the men are just plain abusive.
Yeah.
And the men in, you know, a lot of Asian countries and also a lot of African countries are just plain abusive.
Yeah.
And unfortunately have, you know, towards women I'm speaking, not necessarily towards each other.
Yeah.
But definitely towards women.
Definitely.
Mm.
And I something else I noticed in Latin countries is the use of sex from
as a
both
manipulation
genders.
Tool, yeah.
And women are quite, as I would call it, you know, they rely on sexualizing themselves without making too broad a generalization. But culturally, there is a lot of emphasis on the woman being a sexual object. Sometimes she tries to gain power through that.
Mm.
But I still see that as quite subjugated, just the fact that she has
to do that
to resort
get power.
To that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's sad, isn't it?
It is sad.
Yeah, but that was good, babe, I feel.
Thank you.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah.
You did well there too.
Yeah.
Nice, good reflection of their emotion without... You know, and managed to keep them here without them all running away at different points, which was good.
Yeah. They were really, it was lovely kind of to feel them as well, because they felt very polite almost, and they wanted to do the right thing, and they wanted to learn, teach us. You know, if.
Yeah, they're very ready.
Yeah.
Just very blocked on like one or two emotions.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Yeah, it's really great to have helped them.
Mm. That's good.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully everyone who's listened to that has enjoyed that and we'll have to cut out a bit of their crying so it doesn't take so long, perhaps.
Yeah.
But it was good to be able to sort of help them at least. I feel it illustrates a number of things for us, though. Most people do not want to come face to face with the truth of what's really going on. And this is where they had to have an opening. They had to have an opening to the sin of what they had done, and an opening to the truth about how, you know, other people had treated them badly in order to actually make any progress at all.
So their block really was not wanting, they were kind of torturing themselves, but their block was not seeing the truth about how they had been harmed.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if they had refused to do that, then they wouldn't have been open to the reception of God's love.
Yeah.
And this is where I feel a lot of people make a huge mistake today, is that, you know, when you start talking to them about how the family treats them or how members of the family treated them when they're young, there's so much resistance and anger and rage about it, about even saying anything about it, not about the treatment, but there's a complete denial of the treatment, that it's impossible for God's love to flow and God's truth to flow to tell you what's really going on in your life.
Yeah, I noticed that there's usually like a resistance to feeling how the individual has been harmed, or a feeling that everyone's harming them and they haven't harmed anyone. So one of two blocks I see dominantly.
Yeah, either one just stops any flow.
Yeah, and I've had a little salad.
You mean a mixture of those two on different issues.
On different issues. I definitely, it's probably why I attracted that group, because one of my major blocks at the moment I feel is about resisting. I've done a lot of work on becoming aware of how I'm harming or have harmed others, but I'm finding it hard to work through that causally, because I'm still quite resistive to how I've been harmed.
Mm. Fear is the thing that is the reason why we're so resistive to that. They were so terrified because the men that you can, if you can feel the men have such a short fuse towards violence. In terms of if the women ever complained about their lot in life, the men probably would have killed them or gone close to that.
Yeah, because their addiction would be challenged so much.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And many of the men did do that, actually.
Kill their wives.
Yeah. And in fact, in some countries, it's still lawful to do so.
In Lebanon, where I lived, it's actually not against the law to do a family killing.
Yes.
You know, if a woman shames a family,
then it's,
you can
kill her.
Kill her. The father, the brothers.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, they said, oh, it never happens. But actually, while I was there, it happened.
Mm.
It's very rare now in somewhere like Lebanon. Mm. I don't know about in the Gulf countries.
But in the Asian and African countries, it still goes on.
Yeah. Yes, it does in
very
Africa.
Common.
Yeah, it does. And same with gruesome things like female circumcision and stuff
but,
like that.
You know, even,
that's terrible.
So there's still a lot of bad treatment of women, but it's interesting that many of the women in the West are so angry about the treatment of women, even though that treatment has never happened to them. And in fact, many of those women in the West have treated men badly, and that's where their main problem is.
Yes. Yeah.
So it's just interesting to see people who have sincerely been treated badly, their response in contrast to a woman who's not sincerely been treated badly.
Yeah.
You know, in other words, not really been treated badly.
Mm.
So these women that we channel today have really been treated badly.
Mm. And their major block and impediment towards growth is
coming
as a truth.
To terms with the abuse.
Yeah, is
the major block.
Yeah.
Whereas the women in the West don't have that block, which is an indication they have not been really treated badly, in fact.
Yeah.
And rather is an indication that they've probably treated other people badly in the justification of that emotion.
Yes, and they've inherited some angry feelings either from generationally or from spirits that are around them or a combination. And
both, yeah.
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 Mm. Yeah, I see that a lot.
Mm. Yeah, so it's interesting, isn't it? Just different emotions there for some of our sisters.
Yeah.
And the men too, like how, you know, there's a lot of men I notice, particularly in those same countries, who have no idea whatsoever what bad treatment of a woman is.
No.
None whatsoever. Even in the Western countries.
No.
Many men have no idea what a bad treatment of a woman is. Yeah. None whatsoever.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
So it's good lessons either way.
Quite injured. Mm. I kind of got a vision or something, an impression, when they went to see the men. And it was almost like they were I think it's like from a childhood story. I had like a troll, you know, is all hunched over, kind of wide, facial features kind of flattened and hunched back almost
demonic,
and sort of and just like holding their backs and groping around in the dark almost and sort of all out of proportion, their bodies and stuff.
Still refusing to face anything that they've done.
Yeah, they weren't sort of in pain. They were just sort of, you know, that's not true. It was sort of like they weren't crying out for a change. They were just stuck.
They're just dealing with the consequences of the pain without really even understanding at this point why they're in pain.
Mm. Yeah. And almost like there's no real awareness, even with them, even an awareness of self. Like they're just sort of in this terrible existence.
Yep, very important to deal with some of these emotions and remind our brothers and sisters of such a thing. So hopefully everyone, you've enjoyed our discussion of that channeling and also the channeling itself, and hopefully learnt some things from them, just as our spirit sisters have. Thanks for your time. Thanks for Mary for doing that today.
Thank you, Tom.